in front of me, and inside my sleeve. They are the story entitled The Little Red Riding Hood. Okay, I will start it. Once upon a time, there was a cute little girl who lived in the village. She used to wear a red hood all the time. That's why people called her Little Red Riding Hood. Grandma is not keeping well, so please give this to her. Yes, I will, Mother, if you give me some chocolates. You chocolate monster. Mother gave her a handful of chocolates. But listen, you are too talkative. Don't talk to strangers on the way. Okay, Mother, I will not. Little Red Riding Hood skip off singing along the direction to her grandma's cottage.
Tingle bells, tingles all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride and wear yourself a sleigh. Tingle bells, tingle bells, tingles all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride and wear yourself a sleigh.
Suddenly, a scary looking big red wolf came in her way. Little Red Riding Hood was very scared. Where are you going such a hurry, little girl?
I'm going to visit my grandma, Mr. Wolf.
I see. And the basket, what did you got in the basket?
It's milk and bread for my grandma. She is very ill.
Oh, you are a very sweet girl. You take care of your grandma. Where does your grandma stay?
Down, near the orchard.
The wolf made an effort plan to eat up the little girl. Okay, little girl, but why don't you collect some fresh flower? There are many scented and beautiful flowers in the forest.
That's an awesome idea! Grandma will be very happy and will give me some chocolates. I will collect some dragon flowers.
Okay, go and enjoy. I'm leaving now.
Thank you, Mr. Wolf. Bye-bye!
Little Red Riding Hood started wandering around the forest to collect some flowers. What a sweet milk. I'm very hungry. Okay, I will go to the grandma's cottage first. Eat the grandma and let her swallow the little girl. And then, the wolf ran to the grandma's cottage while the little red riding hood was very busy to collect some flowers. He reached the grandma's cottage and knocked on the door.
Yes, come in. Oh. It's my little baby on the door.
The wolf coughed, but before she could shout, the wolf opened his big mouth and swallowed her food.
Delicious, Grandma, yum.
The wolf wore the grandma's clothes from the cover, and he disguised himself as her. The wolf lay on the bed and waiting for the Little Red Riding Hood. Meanwhile, Little Red Riding Hood on her way. When Little Red Riding Hood reached the cottage, she entered the home and sat next to the grandma.
How are you, Grandma?
I was not feeling well, but
oh my! What big eyes you have, Grandma!
All the better to see you live, my dear.
Oh my! What big teeth you have, Grandma!
All the better to eat you with.
And no sooner the wolf said it, than he bound from the bed and swallowed the poor little girl.
After this happened, he fell asleep
and began to snore loudly. The woodcutter heard the snore as he was passing by the house.
Why the old grandmother snore so widely? I must go check on her.
So he went to the house and saw the little angel, the wolf, lying there.
At last I find you, you old sinner. I have been looking for you since a long time.
So the woodcutter saw some movement in the wolf's stomach, and he thought the wolf had swallowed the grandmother food. So it took a pair of shears and slit up the wolf's stomach. And when the woodcutter made a few snips, the little red rabbit that I could appear, and after more snip, she jumped and cried.
Oh dear, how frightened I have been. It was so dark inside the world.
And then came out the old grandmother, still living and breathing. The little red riding hood went and quickly took a large stone to which and which she filled in the wolf's stomach, and the woodcutter stitched the wolf's stomach again. Soon the wolf woke up and found the one, so he ran out the home.
Oh, how heavy in my stomach. I think the old granny is taking some time to digest.
And then, after a few walks, the wolf getting tired and fell down. And he was thirsty now. And then he went to the river. And then, as the bed to drink the water, he slid down and fell into the river.
Help me! Somebody help me! Help me! Somebody help me!
The granny, Little Red Riding Hood, the woodcutter, reached to the bank and showed him drowning. And then they are very happy. The granny thanked the woodcutter because saved their lives. So she offered him to sit with them and have some kiss. Little Red Riding Hood was very hungry in heart to the sun kiss, but the granny stopped her.
I know you are very greedy to have some eggs and chocolates. I will allow as much as you want today, but before that you must sing your song to the woodcutter.
Their parents, and they must be careful to strangers. We never know about someone. Right.